It's been a rough couple of weeks. What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to The Rundown with Zynga. I'm your host, Zynga. I have to be honest, being a conservative and a Trump supporter is hard, and it's been hard from day one. It was hard to be a conservative pre-Trump, but the moment he came down that escalator and the moment he became the Republican nominee for president, it just made our lives so much harder. We thought we were just voting for the guy that wanted to uplift the little people. We thought we were just voting for the most populist guy on the ballot. We thought we were just voting for the guy that wasn't a politician, but a brawler. We had no idea the battle that would ensue after Election Day in 2016. Trump is the guy that gives no second thought about calling Ish out. But when he calls Ish out, the ugliness of the evil that has been hidden for decades is exposed. And let me tell you, the evil is real ugly. What we've witnessed from the left during Trump's presidency is thoroughly evil. The utter contempt that the left has for liberty-loving, Bible-thumping, stars and stripes-waving Americans has been revealed. That is the ugly. And I can list it out. Let me ask you this. How many minority Republicans have been called racist names for wearing a MAGA hat? How many people have been persecuted by Karens for not wearing a mask in a grocery store? How many businesses have been destroyed by riots, the same riots that Democrats have given a nod of approval to? How many Trump supporters have been attacked for their political leanings? How many friends and family members have disowned Republicans in the last 4 years? How many have lost jobs because they are a Trump supporter? How many bodies have stacked up because of peaceful protests in our major cities? How many Democrats use those riots to blackmail voters? How many Democrats have used the Wu flu, the Chinese virus, the Wuhan virus, the Rona as blackmail to get votes? I could go on and on, and you could too. Many of you know what it's like to take hits for what you believe in. A few weeks ago, as Election Day approached, I was so excited. I dreamt about Trump's re-election. I was so ready for my thirst to be quenched with liberal tears, only to be really disappointed that night when I went to bed. And then to wake up the next morning only to find that Biden was leading in key states, that got me in my feelings. And then over the next few days, watching the evidence of voter fraud stack up in those key states, and then watching the mainstream media ignore that evidence, and then not only watching the mainstream media ignore that mountain of evidence, but also call Sleepy Joe the president-elect, I was pissed. Like, for real, for real. But here is the good news. Our leader is a brawler. And because of his strong leadership, the party is now full of a bunch of Republicans that don't mind going headfirst into a brawl. This isn't over. Here's more good news. We picked up 5 seats in the House. In the Senate, we have 46 Democrats, 48 Republicans, and 2 independents. There are 4 races yet to be declared, and in 3 of those races, Republicans are in the lead. Here in North Carolina, all of our judicial candidates won their race except for one. We're still fighting for Paul Newby. Conservative rock star Madison Cawthorn won his race. Tom Tillis defeated Cheatin' Cal. We kept the majority in the General Assembly. Conservative superstar Mark Robinson beat his opponent. Mike Causey, Dale Falwell, Josh Dobson, Catherine Truitt, Greg Murphy, Patrick McHenry, Steve Troxler, Ted Budd, and Virginia Fox all won their races. Essentially, we whooped up on the Democrats. The blue wave that was supposedly going to happen ended up being a blue puddle. I don't know what the future holds, but this is what I do know. We aren't going to roll over and die. We aren't going to yield to corruption. We aren't going to yield to the far left. We aren't going to give up on Paul Newby or Donald Trump. They fought for us, and we are going to do everything within the law to make sure that their races are fair. Because we are conservatives, and that's what we do. We conserve the traditions and institutions of this country. We don't cheat, we win. We don't lie, we are brutally honest. Someone has to conserve American values. And it looks like fate has chosen us. That's The Rundown, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week.